Why stearic acid has more melting point than oleic acid? Stearic acid and oleic acid, both are the C18 fatty acids. But stearic acid has melting point of 69 degrees centigrade, where oleic acid has the melting point of 13 degrees centigrade. So why stearic acid has having the more melting point than the oleic acid? You can observe a difference of 56 degrees centigrade between the melting points of the stearic acid and oleic acid. Even both are having the same chain length, that is the C18 fatty acids. So the melting point depends on the intermolecular forces. These are the forces between the molecules of a fatty acid, and as the intermolecular forces increases, the melting point increases. So these intermolecular forces depend on two factors. So first one is the chain length, and second one is the degree of unsaturation. So let us see one by one how these factors influence the intermolecular forces, thereby the melting point. So the first one is the chain length. Saturated fatty acids mainly show intermolecular forces like van der Waals forces. So suppose these are the two molecules of a fatty acid. Now these molecules will have intermolecular forces such as the van der Waals forces, and as the chain length increases, the number of contacts increases, thereby the van der Waals forces increases, thereby melting point increases. So as the chain length increases, melting point of the fatty acids increases. Now the saturated fatty acids can be remembered as LMPS, lauric acid, myristic acid, palmitic acid, and stearic acid by increasing their chain length. So let us see their melting points. So lauric acid, which is a C12 fatty acid, which is having the melting point of 44 degrees centigrade. And myristic acid, which is of C14, that means two carbons are added, which is having 58 degrees centigrade. You can see by increase of the two carbons, the melting point is increased from the 44 to 58. And third is the palmitic acid. Palmitic acid is a C16, which is having the 63 degrees centigrade. And finally, stearic acid, which is a C18, and which is having the 69 degrees centigrade. So from this, we can observe that as the chain length increases, the melting point of the fatty acid increases. So second factor is the unsaturation. Unsaturation produces a bend in the molecule. So as the degree of unsaturation increases, the bend in the molecule increases. So as the number of double bonds increases, the molecule renders spherical in nature because of the more bends in the structure. So in case of linear chain, suppose this is a linear chain, you can observe the van der Waals forces between these two molecules of the linear chain. So because of the more contacts, there is a more interaction, thereby more van der Waals forces, hence it is having the more melting point. But in case of a spherical chain, suppose the fatty acid is rendered spherical, not exactly spherical, approximately it renders some spherical nature. Now because of the spherical shape, the point of contacts are less. So spherical chain will have less interaction, thereby the less van der Waals forces. Thereby it will have less melting point. So now let us compare the stearic acid and oleic acid. So stearic acid, which is a C18 saturated fatty acid, which is having the melting point of 69. Oleic acid, which is again C18, having the melting point 13 degrees centigrade. The reason is oleic acid is not equal to the stearic acid. Oleic acid is an unsaturated fatty acid with one double bond. And this is the saturated fatty acid, that is a stearic acid, C18 fatty acid. And now you can see this is the oleic acid, which is again C18 unsaturated fatty acid. And we can start the numbering from the carboxylic acid. And then we can observe the double bond at the 9th position. So which responds for the bend in the structure, thereby the less interaction and less van der Waals forces, thereby less melting point. So stearic acid is having the 69 degrees centigrade, where oleic acid is having the 13 degrees centigrade. Similarly, we can observe the other type of unsaturated fatty acids. So here we can again start the membrane from carbon, and it is having the 18 carbons. So it is again a C18 unsaturated fatty acid. And you can observe the double bonds at the 9th position and 12th position. So you can observe two double bonds in this structure, and this is the linoleic acid, which is a C18 unsaturated fatty acid. Similarly, another structure is again, here we can start the membrane again from the carboxylic acid, and again it is a C18 carbon chain, so it is a C18 fatty acid, and we can observe the double bonds at the 9th position, 12th position and 15th position. So it is having the three double bonds, so this is the linolenic acid. Now linoleic acid is having the melting point -5 degrees centigrade because of the two double bonds, and linoleic acid is having the -11 degrees centigrade because of the three double bonds. So as the number of double bonds increases, the melting point decreases because the molecule have the bent in the structure, which renders the molecule somewhat spherical in nature, leading to less van der Waals forces. So in this way, stearic acid has more melting point than the oleic acid, because stearic acid is a saturated fatty acid, whereas oleic acid is an unsaturated fatty acid with one double bond. So stearic acid is having the 69 degrees centigrade as the melting point, whereas oleic acid is having the 13 degrees centigrade as the melting point.